things. What is free will? Free will is the freedom to exercise that will, or the will to exercise your freedom. It is supposed to be the free choice that every human being has been granted. It is also mentioned that not even God interferes into anybody's free will. So every moment of your life, the whole life, you have been given something called free will, out of which you make choices and then you become a part of its consequences also. Man is exercising his free will every moment in making decisions, in making choices. But if you go more deeper into the higher wisdom of the Upanishads, and if you go into the higher wisdom, deeper wisdom of the self, you will realize that there is actually no freedom. It seems that there is freedom, but there is actually no freedom. It feels that one has the freedom to do anything in this universe, but actually, if you see very closely, it's not so. You might exercise your free will to any extent and then see that you cannot do anything and everything that you really want to do through this life, in this life. There are some things, some powers, or some unseen forces that actually do not allow you to be completely free. What is it? If you just observe and see, you are exercising your free will, and we assume that this is freedom. But in reality, we are never free. Because if we are free, then we should be able to do anything and everything that we so desire. But it is not so. Then why is it that even after exercising the free will of any choice that you make, you cannot completely have control over those choices that you make with your free will? There's something mysterious. Any decision that you make, you will see that there are many forces that control it. Not everything goes according to your will. It shows that there is something called a higher will also. There is a higher will that is actually working on your free will. So the free will is actually an illusion. Why is it so? If you go deep into awareness, if you shift into awareness and contemplate deep on it, you will see that this force that is inhibiting your freedom is Maya. It's a force of illusion. It is the force of this prakriti, of this great play of consciousness, this great illusion that prevents you to be free. But we assume we are free beings. We are not so. Not so till we are bound by Maya. The freedom is only when you transcend this Maya. That is true freedom. And so the soul subconsciously looks for, seeks for freedom. And what this freedom is all about is the freedom from Maya, freedom from illusion. That is why even the most free persons do not fully feel free. They still want to liberate out of something. They are still seeking freedom. This is the translation of that same desire to transcend Maya or illusion. And this is translated as the seeking for liberation, the seeking for moksha, the seeking for mukti. Mukti means liberation or freedom. Freedom from what? We might call as a definition stating that freedom from the cycles of birth and death. But why does the cycle of birth and death happen? because of Maya. So in deeper awareness, it will be revealed that we are all actually seeking liberation, to be free from Maya. And this is only possible, the complete freedom is only possible when one actually is liberated from Maya. Think about it. Divine love and light to you.